Hello, Apacabar, Robert Alberts, Persib Bandung head coach. Thanks for all the questions. I will try to answer them as good as we can in the upcoming videos. Thank you. First of all, I'm good. Thank you for asking. Secondly, daily routine, of course. Checking the news in the morning, both from Indonesia, ASEAN, and of course the world. What is happening, what is the development, and what are we looking for in the near future? And that is taking quite a big part of the morning. After that, I'll get ready. I do my own trainings. I'm a lot on the bicycle, cycle hard for about 1.5 to 2 hours, and then in the evening try to relax. And that's the daily routine at the moment. Also, of course, daily checkup with the coaches, daily checkup with the management, as far as we have time to do so. And then we're checking up with the players also constantly about their feedback, and we monitor that. I think the first thing I will do, and most of us will do, is go straight back to the football field. Meet the players, meet the coaches, meet the staff, start preparing the trainings. Looking forward to start the league, of course, as soon as possible again. And that will be the first thing on my mind. Start the trainings, get everybody motivated, ready, everybody happy, can play football again. And that will be number one on my agenda. In principle, it is not that difficult. We got qualified coaches. We got Yaya, the fitness coach, who is doing all the programs for aerobic and anaerobic. We have Gilan, who is the freeletic coach. We do within the strength exercises, body exercises, and so far the players are following up quite well with that. On top of that, they have their own training schedule. We give them also time to do the schedule. On top of that, we got the menus that they can look after, what is appropriate to eat at the right time. So overall, it is working well, and that gives a positive feedback to all of us, and it gives good motivation to continue with that. We had one season out together. I think one of the matches that stand out in my mind, that is one of the start matches last season, 2019, when we played in Bandung against Madura. And I thought the team started to play some fantastic football. Madura was leading at that time, was the trendsetter in the league. But we outplayed them, totally outplayed them in Bandung, and we played some real good football, the football that we like to play. But the result wasn't there. The result was disappointing at the end of the match. And that match turned around a lot of me in terms of we could play good football, but we couldn't get the results. And we need to go through that. I learned a lot from that match specifically. It was maybe the turning point to start building the team. And we did that very successful after that. We were the only team now 2020, in the new season, 3 matches and unbeaten with a good record as well in goal difference. So that match against Madura, good football, but not a good result. Yes, we do. We checked their weights, but obviously it is not only now the pandemic, it is also the factor of the Ramadan, and normally during Ramadan players might lose a little bit of weight. It is important to see what will happen once we come back. Where is the weight of the players? Are we continue again the weight measurements that we had before we stopped the season? We have given the players menus, what they should eat, when they should eat, when they should train, to maintain themselves and hopefully also maintain with that the weight. But because we are not together, it's difficult to control. Most of our players are professional enough to do that, but we will see when we come back. They must also enjoy sometimes now, especially when Eid al-Fitr is coming up, that they also have the allowance to, of course, eat something and enjoy with the relatives and the family in this difficult time, in a different situation than normal. So let's see when they come back, and I hope everybody's in a good weight. very speculative question, obviously. We don't know. We are all tuned in and hoping for the league will resume in July. The PSSA has made it very clear in their letter, 27th of March, we have received a letter that if there's no more emergency in the country by the 28th of May, we might resume training in June and the league would restart in July. And that is, of course, what we're looking for. I can't see any problem if leagues in the other parts of the world are opening up and training has restarted in countries much more affected than Indonesia. So I would think it is possible that we start the league. I wouldn't even like to think yet that the league will stop, because that is only speculation at the moment. So let's hope the league will resume, the players can play and we can start watching it on TV in the beginning, but obviously we have to be very secured about the safety measurements, and big gatherings obviously are still out for quite a while because it can spread very fast again. But I'm optimistic that we can start the league, and obviously with the same squad that we have, because we started well and we want to continue with it. We are making videos and we give the players also some motivational work to do. The videos are based on aerobic training, anaerobic training, lower and upper core muscles, ab muscles, body strength. So we have a complete program 4 times a week on the videos that the players should follow. Besides that, they have their own training, their own recovery. On this coming Monday, we will start the last 3 weeks of our preparation before we resume training in June, as I explained earlier. And that will be more intensive, and there will be shorter rest periods in between. So we start adapting again to a quick recovery. Some countries restarting the league or starting the league, and some countries restarting training with possibility for the league to start very soon. And I think if these countries, and many of them has been hit much worse than Indonesia, can do it, obviously we also can do it. If we can start the K-League, it started yesterday actually. Was very good response from what I gather so far. The Vietnamese league will start, which is quite similar to our league. We see already Italy, Spain, they all start training. German league start in 2 weeks also. So yes, the trend is to reopen. And like I said, in Indonesia, although we have to follow the rule by the PSSI and the government, I can only see positive signs. We can play in empty stadiums. We must make sure there's a strict control on safety measurements. We must also make sure that nobody can come close or enter to the stadium, which is quite normal. You surround the stadium with guards and barricades, and nobody will even get close to the stadiums, which is happening in other countries also. Yeah, that is not easy, because we are all isolated. Everybody must stay home and in their own environment do the training. So lucky that I would think all the players have their FIFA games, and I think many are linked up to each other from what I understand, and of course that gives them a competitive edge, although it is a game on television, but it gives the players the motivation to want to win and to see the moves on the field and to know where to pass to and to see the openings. But of course to have the match mentality, the match winning attitude, yeah, that we can only produce once we come back on the field. Alright, that was all the questions then that we need to answer. Thank you for sending them, and I hope that some of the answers have been useful to you. Nyahiji, bagus.